Good morning, Collierville Dragons. My name is Nick Douglas. Today is Monday, October 26th, and you're watching Collierville AM. Here's a reminder to stay safe this week, Dragons. Wear your mask, wash your hands, and continue to socially distance. In national news, over 60 million Americans have already cast a ballot for the 2020 U.S. election. That surpasses the total number of early votes cast in 2016, which was 58.3 million. Early voting broke records within a matter of days, and it seems as if election day lines will be much shorter. In local news, after more than 100 years in business, Steinmart is closing all stores. Steinmart, founded in Greenville, Mississippi in 1908, has closed its Eastgate, Memphis location for good on Sunday. The Collierville and Cordova locations will close today. All 279 locations are closing due to bankruptcy. Steinmart is another one of many major retailers that have filed for bankruptcy during the pandemic. It's Monday, Dragons, and you know what that means. Great to see you here, Mr. Jones. How was your weekend?
It was just fine, thank you for asking, Nick.
So this first question is about the second semester. With everything going on, how do you envision a spring semester at Collierville High School?
Well, with respect to the spring semester, some of the things that I think we all need to know, the district already decided from the very beginning that come the second semester, they would revisit the plan in terms of what we would be doing, whether all students would be coming back or what capacity we're going to have them. Some of you may or may not already know that the Shelby County Health Department last week issued a new directive that gave school districts the autonomy to decide how they want to operate in what capacity, whether they bring students back or what have you. So our district is evaluating that aspect as well. Another thing that many of you may not know because you're hybrid is that an email went out, which again, the district stated that they would do this from the very beginning. To those students that are currently virtual, just ask those parents whether or not those students are intending to come back for second semester. I assume that something probably will be going out very soon this week with hybrid students, just asking them the exact same thing in terms of whether they choose to go virtual or what have you. Again, if you recall, the district stated that everyone would be able to reevaluate their decisions come second semester. So I anticipate that all of that information will be able to go out, and very soon everyone will know exactly what's going to happen, whether we all come back for 5 days, full week, whatever that capacity is going to be. Virtual will still be here, of course, because that option was going to be guaranteed throughout the whole entire school year for those parents and those students that just simply say they're not safe coming onto campus. So we'll see, Nick, in the very near future how that's going to pan out.
Awesome. So the next question is about the class of 2021. I know our senior class has been through a lot. Do you have a message for them?
I do. Seniors, I just want to say to you, I know that this has been a very unpredictable year for you all, for everyone, for that measure. I would say that I hope that you all are journaling, number one, about this school year, about how things have been going for you and how things, how you've been dealing with things, because this is definitely going to be one for the ages. We just want you to know that we definitely care about you. We want to see the absolute very best for all of our seniors. I know that this is a year that is like no other in terms of a lot of the things that you typically would come to expect and come to enjoy. We just simply cannot do some of them. But we do have a few things that are planned in the works for seniors, and we hope to be able to bring some sense of normalcy and hopefully be able to celebrate you in the end in some capacity. So I wish you all the very best this school year. We're going to do our very best for you to make sure that you have a great school year, and we'll get through this together.
Thank you for your time again, Mr. Jones. And do you have a final message for students?
My only final message is I just want to say to all of you again, it's Monday, so welcome to school this Monday. Whether you're hybrid, whether you're virtual, I got the opportunity I'll share with you all to check out our girls volleyball team this past weekend in Murfreesboro. If you've never seen them in action, you truly missed a treat. The girls are, these ladies are fabulous representation of our school. They did an awesome job. We fell short in the tournament, state championship tournament, but they did an excellent job representing our school. We're so proud of you. But again, happy Monday to everyone, and go Dragons.
Listen up, Dragons. The 2020 presidential election is 8 days away. Here's your fact of the day. This election is between current President Donald Trump and former Vice President Joe Biden, in case you didn't know. Whoever wins will be the oldest U.S. president ever. Your vote, your vote, your voice. Now for some announcements. Our Lady Dragons soccer team defeated Arlington High School last Saturday and secured a spot at state. Congratulations, ladies. Attention all sophomores, juniors, and seniors interested in being a member of the Beta Club. Application information is now available on the Beta Club page on the CHS website. It is also posted outside of room A412, room A923, and in the library. The deadline for applying is 2:30 on Friday, November 6th. Attention all sophomores and juniors. 2021 Governor School applications are now available for this highly competitive program. There's something for everyone. Information is on the class of 2022 and 2023 Schoology pages. Please contact your counselor if you have any questions. Juniors and seniors, it's not too late to order your class ring. Balfour will be back at school this Tuesday and Wednesday during all lunches in the cafeteria. A minimum $60 deposit is required to place your order. That's all we have for you today, Collierville. My name is Nick Douglas, and have a mobbin' Monday.